Hello and welcome to another class of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. In this class, I will be showing you how to use Ajax within Scriptcase and apply it within the available application. During this video, I will be using the form application, but this does also apply to all applications where Ajax would be required, such as within the control application, for example. Ajax is a developer's dream because you can read data from a web server after the page has loaded, update a web page without reloading the page. And you can also send data to a web server in the background without the user actually noticing. And with Scriptcase, it is no different whatsoever. Within Scriptcase, you can use Ajax in various ways. One of those is by applying it to select fields. You can apply a lookup to reload information. For instance, if you have a select field which is related to another select field, then you can have one load the data of the other without having to reload the page. This is what's called Ajax processing. Okay, so let me show you an example of this. Within this form, I have two select fields, both of which have related tables. When I select one, it will update the other. Let's take a look at this within Scriptcase and see how Ajax is applied. Within the left menu, I have the two fields, the state ID and the city, which were both used within the form. Now, selecting the state ID, you can see here that I have the Ajax processing applied. The city field is on which is indicated by the asterisk. Then viewing the city field, we can see that within the SQL statement, we have a where statement included. This example is available within the Scriptcase samples, form 49. Another way to use Ajax within Scriptcase is by applying Ajax events to individual fields. There are various Ajax events available within Scriptcase. There is the click, change, focus, and blur events, each of which apply Ajax abilities with some ease. Let's take a look at the Ajax events which are available within the left-hand menu. They're clicking on Ajax events. We have the option to create a new Ajax event. The first thing we need to do is select the field which we want to create the event for. So I will this time select the state ID as an example, and then we need to select the event for Ajax processing. Now we have the option for onChange, onClick, onBlur, and onFocus. I will start with the onChange event. The onChange event, whenever you change the field's value, then the Ajax event will be triggered. To show you how the onClick event is triggered, I will create the onChange event on this selected field. I will select create event, and then within the editor, I will add an echo statement, and within the echo statement, I will add onChange triggered. Now running the application, and now within the form application, when I select the state ID and change it, I now receive the event. The next event is then the onFocus event. So I will again select the same field, date ID. I will this time select the onFocus event and click create event. Now I will also go ahead and delete the onChange event as you won't be needing that no more for this example, and access the state ID onFocus event. For the onFocus event, whenever the field receives focus, the Ajax event will then be triggered. To show you how the onFocus event is being triggered, I will create a new onFocus event for the selected field and again create an echo. And again, this time I will say onFocus triggered. And now if I run the form again, and now when the state field receives focus, the event is then triggered. Let's go back into Scriptcase and check the next event. I'll again go ahead and delete the onFocus event and create a new Ajax event, again selecting the state ID field. This time I will select the onBlur event. For the onBlur event, whenever the field loses focus, the Ajax event will be triggered. I will then create the event and again add an echo statement and onBlur triggered. I will again run the application and return back to the form. And now when I select the state field and then remove focus from it, the onBlur event is triggered. Now it is important to note here that the onFocus event comes before the onBlur event. I'm going to have one final event to check out. So I will again remove the onBlur event and again add a new Ajax event, again selecting the state ID field And this time I will select the onClick event. I will go ahead and create the event and again add an echo statement. And onClick triggered. I will again run the form application. And this time when I now click the state field, the event is triggered. Thank you for watching this part of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. I hope to see you again soon in the next class.